Good morning. I hope all of you are happy and safe. Welcome back to yet another section of Indian Writing in English. We are going through R.K. Narayan's Mars in the Seventh House. We went through R.K. Narayan's career, life, personal life, his major works, his writing style, etc. in detail. And we started the short story Mars in the Seventh House. Then actually the story starts with his infatuations. After the infatuation, he really fell in love with a 50-year-old girl, Rajam. He revealed his love at first towards her father, the headmaster. The headmaster was ready to arrange the marriage with him and his daughter. But horoscope was the problem. But we also found it in detail. Even he has the Mars in seventh house, but with the help of Velappa, he solved the problem and he married Rajam. Then he spoke about his job. I think all of you remembered well. When he married Rajam, he was working in a newspaper, The Justice. Then he talked a lot about his work in The Justice. Then we identified he faced financial crisis when he was working in the newspaper The Justice. Even he faced a lot of problems based on his job, but he enjoyed as a reporter. He met a lot of friends through this. He made a lot of relationship through this work as a reporter. Then when he was going through this financial crisis, he got a pleasant message from his friend Purna. He already sent his first novel, Swami and Friends, to him. Even he approached so many publishers, but he didn't get a positive reply from those publishers. Actually, he fed up and he already decided to throw it, his first novel, Swami and Friends. Then when he was faced that financial crisis, he got a pleasant message from his friend Purna. With the help of Graham Greene, the work Swami and Friends, it is going to publish. Definitely it was a great moment in the narrator's life. Then I think all of you remembered well, Hamish Hamilton, he published the first work of R.K. Narayan, Swami and Friends, by the influence of Graham Greene. But unfortunately, it was a sad failure. So Hamilton was not at all ready to publish his second work, Bachelor of Arts. After 20 years, Hamish Hamilton met him again with Graham Greene. And even that moment, he just reminded him, I was the first publisher of your first book, Swami and Friends. Till that, we already discussed in our last classes. Okay, so all of you please take the page number 48. Okay, I think all of you are ready with the page number 48. So let us start. Second paragraph. Thanks again to Graham Greene's recommendation. The Bachelor of Arts was published by Nelson, fulfilling a fancy I had entertained several years before when a Nelson representative had come from Edinburgh to see my father about the supply of books for our high school library. I had confided to this salesman, if I write a book, will you ask your company to publish it? Undoubtedly, he had said and given me his card. Change after February 1937. My father lived up to the last date of the month, as if to satisfy technical need, and died leaving us to draw his pension for the full month. That was all the resources we were left with. My father never believed in savings, property and such things. I told you, actually Hamish Hamilton, he was not at all ready to publish his second work, Bachelor of Arts. With the help of Graham Greene, he met another publisher, he is Nelson. Finally Nelson was ready to publish his second novel, Bachelor of Arts. And I want to add one point relating Graham Greene. Actually, I already revealed all these points in our first class. Graham Greene, he told so many changes in the Bachelor of Arts to influence the English reader. According to that, R.K. Narayan made the changes. Then, with the help of Graham Greene, Nelson was ready to publish his second novel, Bachelor of Arts. Then, he is speaking about his father's death. Then, father, actually, he didn't possess wealth for his children. So because he didn't have any savings, property and such other things. Now we feared a total economic collapse, but we managed. My elder brother, now back from Madras, as an experiment had opened a small shop in a new extension and called it a National Provision Stores. Sinu had a government job and moved off to Bangalore. Mine was still a pure gamble. Sometimes I wished that I had not given up the justice, but I was sustained by the gambler's inhospitable hope and a macabre-ish anticipation of something turning up. With a second novel published and daughter added to the family, life seemed to be not so bad. Short stories were being accepted in India as well as abroad. Graham Greene helping me in London. So after all, my claim to the editor of the Justice about contacts with the London editors was being fulfilled. Although it had perhaps been premature, the great God who could view the past, present and future as one block would have realized, I had not been false. Then he is speaking about the financial status of his entire family. We can see that his elder brother, he started a shop. It was called as National Provision Stores. Then his another brother, Sinu, he got a government job and he became settled in Bangalore. About him, actually, he was still a pure gambler. He had a financial crisis. Then those period, they were blessed with a baby girl. Then even when he faced such a financial crisis, he thought that why I resigned the job from the Justice. Anyway, that's why he says, who can predict one's past, present and future? Because we can't predict that when our life will be changed. Okay, actually all these things we already discussed in our last class. Okay, I repeated till again it. So page number 48, last para. My brother and I shared the household expenses. He looked after the supplies and miscellaneous items of expenditure, and I had to see that the house rent was paid. All aspects of shelter were to be my responsibility. Ram Vilas, in which we lived, was to be retained at any cost. There could be no question of our moving to another house. Fortunately, our house owner lived in Bangalore and only came down to Mysore once a month to collect the rent. I told him once, the rent is my responsibility. I have no fixed income. If my book sells, the royalty will come in only in December and June. So please permit me settle the rent once every 6 months. Although I will pay into your bank account whatever amount I am able to earn meanwhile. He was good enough to accept this arrangement. Now I had a scrappy, fitful income from various sources. In addition to other items, I had to find money for baby food, gripe water and toys. I did a variety of writings, humorous articles every week for a Mary magazine at 10 rupees a week. Okay. Then again he is speaking about how he managed his life without a steady income. I told you still actually his first two novels were published, but he didn't get a proper income according to that, because the first novel, when the first novel Swami and Friends published, actually it was a sad failure. Okay, I think, well, if you remembered well, that's why Hamish Hamilton was not at all ready to publish his second novel, Bachelor of Arts. Then that is why he had a financial crisis, and he and his brother shared the household expenses. He had the responsibility to pay the rent. So he already made an agreement with the house owner. He should be ready to pay the month in December and June, because he can arrange the money only in December and June. So even his house owner, he was in Bangalore. That's why it is not easy for him to come to Mysore every month to collect the rent. So he also agreed that. Then I think all of you remembered well, they had a girl child. So definitely beyond that, he should arrange baby food, grape wine, toys for their daughter. So he should arrange the money for her also, her expenses also. Then that's why he started to write. He started to write in variety of magazines. Then we can see that he started to work, started to write the humorous article every week for a Mary magazine. Underline that. He started to work for a Mary magazine. There he wrote humorous article. He wrote humorous articles for Mary magazine. Okay. Then every week for a Mary magazine at 10 rupees a week. When he wrote the humorous article every week for Mary magazine, he got the income. It was just 10 rupees. Okay. Then a most taxing experience for the two, perform a 1,000-word literary clowning week after week. I had also begun my third novel, The Dark Room. Actually, that period he started to write after the birth of his daughter. He started to write his third novel, that it is The Dark Room. So you please go through my first class. Actually, in my first class, in my second class, I already went through the Bachelor of Arts and Dark Room in detail. Okay. So this period, he started to write his third novel, The Dark Room. I took a pad and pen and disappeared every morning for 3 hours. I found it impossible to write at home now. There were far too many worrying distractions and also the baby. She was just a little over a year old, and I found it impossible to remain at my desk when she was around. Since my wife often left her in my care while she was busy in the kitchen or in the garden gathering flowers for my mother's daily worship, I had also a routine duty to carry my daughter to let her watch the pink bougainvillea flowers over the compound wall of Reverend Sode's bungalow at the corner. She would gaze at the bench of flowers for about 10 minutes with rapt attention, and then I would have to lift her up to give her a glimpse of a white terrier that barked and frisked about inside the Reverend's compound. Only then would I be free to deposit her at home and leave. Then I told you, after the birth of their daughter, he started to write his third novel, Dark Room. Actually, he wanted to, he spent the time to write this novel in the morning. But he was very busy in every morning, because he got the responsibility to take care of their daughter, because her wife Rajam was busy in kitchen. That's why every morning he gave the responsibility to take care of their daughter to the narrator. So he couldn't concentrate in his writing because he was very busy to look after their daughter. So he had a fixed schedule in his life. Then we already noticed that how he spent the time with their daughter. He had the habit to let her watch the pink bougainvillea flowers over the compound wall of Reverend Sode's bungalow. After that, both of them spent the time in front of a white terrier. Terrier means a small dog. Okay. Then after that, when he handed over their daughter to his wife Rajam, he became free. Then only he got the time to write the third novel, The Dark Room. Actually, it was a busy time schedule for him. Okay. Before sending me out, my wife would give me a cup of coffee and sometimes whisper a warning, "Don't make a fuss. Not enough coffee powder at home. Get some at the store when you return." I set out to do my writing at the college union, where the secretary had given me a room. I shut myself in for 3 hours, gazed on the green football field outside, across the street, and spun out the feet of Savitri, the heroine of The Dark Room. I was somehow obsessed with the philosophy of woman as opposed to man, her constant oppressor. This must have been an early testament of the women's liberation movement. Man assigned her a secondary place and kept her there with such subtlety and cunning that she herself began to lose all notion of her independence, her individuality, stature, and strength. A wife and orthodox milieu of Indian society was ideal victim and such circumstances. My novel dealt with her. With this philosophy broadly in the background, I wrote nearly 1,000 words before I went back home for lunch, exhausted but also feeling triumphant at having done my quota of work for the day. Okay, so I told you, he was writing his third novel, The Dark Room. So we already identified it is very difficult to write the third novel in his house because he had got the responsibility to take care of their child, their daughter. That's why he arranged the time in the college union. They already arranged a room for him, so he spent every 3 hours in that room, and he started to write the third novel, The Dark Room. Okay, and the novel, it is about the heroine of the novel The Dark Room is Savitri. So he is speaking about the women's liberation movement. Actually, by taking noon time, he wrote more than 1,000 words before the lunch. That was his daily routine. Then I am not at all repeating the novel summary, The Dark Room's summary, because I have already spoken detail about the third novel, The Dark Room, in my second class relating Mars in the seventh house. Okay, The Dark Room, once again read and approved by Graham Greene, was published by Macmillan in 1938. I had the unique experience of having a new publisher for each book. One book, one publisher. And then perhaps he said to himself, hands off this writer, Hamish Hamilton, then Nelson, now Macmillan. Again, we can see that even Graham Greene, he also helped to publish the third novel, The Dark Room. With the help of him, he published the third novel, The Dark Room. Actually, he is very blessed because he got three publishers to publish his three novels. First novel, Swami and Friends, it was published by Hamish Hamilton. Second novel, Bachelor of Arts, it was published by Nelson. Then the third novel, it is Dark Room, it is published by Macmillan. Even all these novels are published with the help and advice of his friend Graham Greene. So this is our short story, Mars in the seventh house. Actually, he is sharing his own life through this simple short story, Mars in the seventh house. So he started this short story with his infatuations. We already met 3 or 4 girls, how he fell in love with them. Then finally he met his real girl in Coimbatore, near the public pipe. She is Rajam. She was just 15 years old. Then with the help of Rajam's father, the headmaster, he married her. Horoscope was the villain between them, but somehow they managed the problem with the help of Velappa. Then after that, he talked about the financial crisis when he was working as a freelance reporter in the paper The Justice. Then with the help of Graham Greene, finally he published 3 novels. Yes, Swami and Friends, Bachelor of Arts, finally The Dark Room. Once again I repeat, Swami and Friends, it was published by Hamish Hamilton. Then second book, Bachelor of Arts, published by Nelson. Then third novel, The Dark Room, it was published by Macmillan. In between that, he also worked in a magazine. You don't forget that Mary magazine. Actually, there he worked humorous. He wrote a humorous article every week. Okay, that's all. These are the details relating his simple short story, Mars in the seventh house. So I think all of you understood the story very well. So we can discuss the question answers. Okay. So all of you, please take the textbook, page number 51. Then it is easy for you to listen me. Okay, the first question: why did R.K. Narayan long for some engineering business? Have you remembered it well? Yes. Actually, the story starts with his infatuation. And even he first fell in love with a girl in green sari. She had a brother. Her brother was an engineer. Have you remembered all these things? Yes, that's why. So he wanted to make a good relationship with his brother. That was his style. Even he relieved his love towards his towards Rajam's father, not her. Okay, so we can move to the answer. R.K. Narayan became devoted to a girl who was the sister-in-law of an engineer. So he wished that he had some engineering business so that he could make frequent visits to the engineer, and in the meantime he could meet his sister-in-law whom Narayan loved. Okay, then the second question: why did he befriend the headmaster? I think all of you know it well. Am I right? Who is the headmaster? Yes, Rajan's father. Narayan befriended the headmaster because he loved the headmaster's daughter. Moreover, the headmaster was a book lover and interested in literary matters. They had many common subjects to talk about. That is also very important, because I think if you remembered well, even he was busy to seek for a girl to fall in love. At that period, actually, he was interested to read a lot of books. So he had the habit to imagine the life relating those books, those novels. So even the headmaster was also interested to read books. So that's why there is a common factor to connect between the headmaster and the narrator. Okay, so that's why both of them can easily talk about the books, politics, and so many general topics. Okay, but the main aim was, no doubt, it is Rajam. Then the third question: discuss the theme of how to write an Indian novel. Actually, we already spoke about his style, writing style and language, all these things in detail in our first class. Okay. Anyway, for a short story, short answer, I want to give the points like this. The small piece of writing that Narayan did was how to write an Indian novel. This was a piece which severely criticized Western writers who visited India to gather material. Okay. Then next question: an instance of two wrongs making one right in horoscope. According to Narayan, do you think such beliefs have any scientific basis? What are such beliefs called? I think if you remembered well the situation, actually horoscope was the real villain between Rajam and R.K. Narayan. Because the Mars in the seventh house, that was the problem in Narayan's horoscope. But Velappa revealed that in Rajam's horoscope, there is another problem. That's why it will be matched with Narayan's. When we ask, such beliefs have any scientific basis? I think no. Because we haven't still proved it. So we have a lot of conflicts relating that. Okay, anyway, we can go to the answer. The horoscope of R.K. Narayan and that of the headmaster's daughter, whom he loved, were incompatible. Narayan's horoscope had the seventh house occupied by Mars. This indicated disaster unless the partner's horoscope also contained the same flow, which according to Narayan is two wrongs making one right. Such beliefs have no scientific basis. Such beliefs are called superstitions. Okay, then we can move to the next question. What according to you would be the theme of the Home of Thunder? I think all of you remembered well when he wrote the play The Home of Thunder, when he already fell in love with Rajam. He revealed his love towards Rajam, not directly to Rajam but to her father, the headmaster. Then headmaster was okay with that affair, but the horoscope was the villain. Okay, then he revealed that without the support of family and horoscope, he couldn't do anything. Those days actually he became very sad. Then he started to write the play, which is the play The Home of Thunder. Then it is reflecting his own life. So The Home of Thunder would be a frightful tragedy in which the principal characters are struck dead by lightning on a tower open to the skies, the play ending with a clap of thunder. Okay. But those correspondents were lofty and did not care for the items I valued. What do you infer? I think these lines, it is from the work, how he worked in the newspaper, The Justice. I told you in detail about his busy schedule while he was working in the newspaper, The Justice. Then he had a daily routine. He visited police station, courts, like that, the fixed places to collect the news items. And the correspondents who are working in the Hindu, the other newspapers, they have modern technology. That is why they can easily send their news. But here R.K. Narayan depended to send his news items by post, so it should take time. But actually there was no competition among the other correspondents and R.K. Narayan. Okay, so R.K. Narayan became a news reporter. His business was to gather Mysore city news and sent it daily to a newspaper in Madras called The Justice. There were the popular newspapers published from Madras. The correspondents of these newspapers had telephone and telegraph facilities. He feared that they might get ahead of him, but they were very high people and did not collect news of this kind. So he could continue as the reporter of The Justice. Okay, the next question. Why do you think Narayan worked for The Justice even though he knew that it was a propagandist paper against the Brahmin class? Okay, in my first class I already spoke in detail about the newspaper The Justice, why he selected R.K. Narayan as a reporter in that paper. Okay, actually though the justice was a propagandist paper against Brahmin class, Narayan worked for it because the management somehow did not mind having him as its correspondent in Mysore. Okay. The next question, how did Narayan escape the danger of being holed up for false reporting or contempt of court in Nanchagud and Chambarajnagar? When there was a scarcity of news, Narayan reported murders from Nanchagud and Chambarajnagar at the extreme south of Mysore district. The police brought a stream of murder case. He hung about the mortuary for the postmortem verdict and first police report. He uses the expression alleged liberally, and so there was no danger of being hauled up for false reporting. So it is very important. That's why he brilliantly used the word alleged. Because there was no danger of being hauled up for false reporting. Okay, that's very important. The next question, write a note on the unhappy end to Narayan's job as a newspaper report. I think all of you remembered well, there was an issue with the the newspaper authorities. That's why especially the editor, because every day he edited his news items, he started to cut short it maximum. So like that, there was an issue between the editor and R.K. Narayan. So we can go to it in detail. The newspaper authorities withheld his payments for 3 months. He wrote to them saying that he was a writer in contact with many newspapers and periodicals in America and England who made their payments on precise dates. The editor wrote to him, if he was so eminent as he claimed to be, should not mind a slight delay on their part. He resented the tone of the reply and decided to give that work as early as he could afford. Actually, the editor insulted him because he cut short all the news items. More than that, he didn't give the salary properly. So that's why he questioned the editor and he insulted him. That's why he decided to quit the job from that newspaper, The Justice. Why did Narayan feel guilty whenever he saw his wife in the green sari? I think all of you remembered well that situation. Actually, after marriage, he bought a green sari for his wife Rajam. He didn't have the money to buy that sari with the whole amount. Actually, he bought that sari as an installment, and even he suffered a lot to pay the money as an installment. Somehow he paid it. Okay, I think it was just 60 rupees. So he faced such a financial crisis at those period. So Narayan promised his wife a sari and bought her one on credit costing about 60 rupees. The shopman agreed to take installments of 10 rupees on 4th of every month. He could not make his payment on the due date. Until he paid back his debt, he felt guilty whenever he saw his wife in the green sari. Okay, then we can move to the next question. Why did Hamish Hamilton reject the second novel? Have you remembered Hamish Hamilton? Yes. With the recommendation of Graham Greene, Hamish Hamilton published R.K. Narayan's first novel, Swami and Friends. But unfortunately, it was a sad failure. That is the reason. That's why he was not at all ready to publish his second novel, Bachelor of Arts. Hamish Hamilton rejected the second novel, saying that Swami and Friends was a sad failure. He thought that the second one, Bachelor of Arts, was not going to do any better. He added that someone would prove him wrong someday. Okay. The next question, who was Narayan's literary promoter in London? I think all of you know the answer well. Yes, we repeated so many times the relationship between Graham Greene and the narrator. Narayan's literary promoter in London was Graham Greene, who had been his long friend. Okay, then we can move to the paragraph questions. Narayan's infatuation for a pen friend in England. It is very important question. University repeatedly asks this question. Okay. I think if you remembered well, the infatuation for a pen friend in England. He kept all those letters till his marriage. So Narayan in his younger days would fall in love with girls at first sight. But the love was only one-sided. His most impossible infatuation was for a pen friend had in England. They exchanged letters every week. So she sent her photograph and he sent her his. He kept her photo in his breast pocket and hoped that she would do the same. Even if he wished to reach her, it would mean a voyage of 4 weeks. He wrote impatient love letters which she rejected outright. She wrote back impersonal letters describing a holiday in Britain or her latest collection of stamps. Though she protested against the tone of his letters, she never stopped writing, and that seemed to him a hopeful sign. He continued to write to her expressing his great love for her. She also continued to send him impersonal replies. He collected and kept the letters till her marriage. After that, he threw them over the wall. So I think all of you got the idea about Narayan's infatuation for a pen friend in England. Actually, every week they already wrote letters. He wrote love letters, but she wrote the letters relating her stamp collections, then her visit in Britain, etc. Actually, it was impersonal letters. But she didn't speak any words relating his love letters. Okay. Then Rajam's competence in housekeeping. I already told you, R.K. Narayan met Rajam when she was just 15 years old. And after the marriage, R.K. Narayan's father became ill and she got the responsibility to take care of whole family. His three brothers, the entire thing of the family. Household works, to control the maids, etc. Whatever it is, he handled all these things well. Even she was just below 20 years, she managed well. More than that, she got the appreciation from R.K. Narayan's mother. Okay. Rajam, Narayan's wife, helped Narayan's mother in looking after his ailing father. She managed Narayan's three younger brothers who were still at school. She cooked food, worked like a general servant and cared his elder brother's pet dog. She kept an eye on the stores, supplying the foodstuffs and guarding them from being stolen by the cook. Though she was below 20, she managed the housekeeping expertly and it won her mother-in-law's prize. She got an excellently well with Narayan's brothers. This, Narayan says, is one advantage of the joint family system. One had plenty of company at home. Within 6 months, Rajam proved herself such an expert in housekeeping that her mother-in-law left her in complete charge. As a result of this, Narayan and his wife found time to exchange pleasantries and intimacies only when she took a little time off during the day and went into his room or at night after everyone had retired and kitchen doors was shut. Through this narration, we can also identify the blessings of being the part of a joint family. It has its own positive and negative sides. Anyway, Rajam was a very smart girl. She proved her ability as a wife, as a daughter-in-law, whatever it is. She got the appreciation from the entire family. Okay, then we can move to the next question. Narayan as a newspaper reporter. It is very important because we already met in detail the issues he faced while he was working as a reporter in the newspaper, The Justice. But whatever the problems he faced, actually he enjoyed his job as a reporter. Okay. In order to have a stable income, Narayan became a newspaper reporter. His business was to collect news from Mysore city and send it daily to newspaper published in Madras called The Justice. The daily was intended to promote the cause of the non-Brahmin who suffered from the domination of the minority Brahmin class in public life, government services and education. Though The Justice was a propagandist paper against the Brahmin class, it did not mind Narayan as its correspondent in Mysore. He left home at 9 in the morning and went out news hunting through the bazaar and marketplace all on foot. He hung about law courts, police stations and the municipal building and tried to make up at least 10 inches of news each day before lunchtime. He would return home and have quick lunch and then would type the news items with appropriate heading. Then he signed and sealed the report in an envelope and posted the Chamarajapuram post office. Sometimes his brother Lakshman would post it for him. Narayan feared that the correspondents of the Mail or the Hindu who had telephone and telegraph facilities might get ahead of him. But those correspondents were lofty and did not care for the items he valued. He collected murder reports. In order to escape contempt of court, he used the expression alleged liberally. His remuneration was 3 rupees and 8 annas per column of 21 inches. The news editor always abridged it to the minimum so that he could be paid less. The payment was sometimes delayed. Once he wrote a letter about the delayed payment to which they replied harshly. He thought of stopping it as early as he could afford. He voluntarily stopped that work on the day his friend Purna cabled him saying that his first novel, Swami and Friends, had been taken for publication. Okay, then we can move to the next question. Narayan's experience at getting his first book published. Okay, actually, he faced a lot of struggles to publish his first novel, Swami and Friends. Finally, with the help of his friend Purna, he met Graham Greene, and with the recommendation of Graham Greene, Hamilton was ready to publish his first novel, Swami and Friends. Unfortunately, it was a sad failure. Okay, Narayan's friend Purna left for Oxford in August 1931, promising him to find a publisher for the first novel, Swami and Friends. When he had completed his book, he faithfully dispatched it to Ellen and Unwin, but it was returned. Then he sent it to another publisher and another. He used to get back the rejected manuscript in about every 6 weeks. He repeated this as a mechanical process. The last publisher to return it was Dent. So you should keep in memory all these publishers. First he sent to Allen and Unwin. It was rejected. Then he sent to another publisher and another. Like that he continued. Finally, he sent to the publisher. It was sent. To them, he had advised in a covering letter to forward the manuscript when rejected to Purna at Exeter College, Oxford. Finally, that novel returned back to Purna, his friend. He sent a parallel letter to Purna advising him to weigh the manuscript with a stone and down it in the Thames because he already lost the faith. Purna took the manuscript and went from publisher to publisher in London. After trying them all, he wrote to Narayan that his book may not be ever taken, but he should not despair. Graham Greene was in London at that time. Purna took the manuscript to him. He recommended the novel to Hamish Hamilton, who accepted it immediately. That was somehow Narayan's first novel published. Okay, then we can move to the next question. Narayan and the mass in the seventh house. Narayan once escorted his elder sister and stayed with her in Coimbatore for some time. He saw a girl drawing water from a nearby street tap and immediately fell in love with her. He learned that she was the daughter of a school headmaster who lived not far from his sister's house. The headmaster was a book lover and Narayan somehow befriended him. They found many common subjects for talk. One evening, Narayan interrupted the talk and made a bold, blunt announcement of his affection for his daughter. The headmaster was taken aback but did not show it outside. It was quiet and conventional for a young man to make a proposal directly. A marriage proposal could proceed only between the elders of families. The headmaster only said, "If God wills it." He said that he had to consult his wife and women folk in the family. Finally, the horoscope of the boy and girl were to be studied. The headmaster also inquired about his income and asked him why he did not try for a job in Bangalore using his father's influence. The headmaster himself was an expert at the study of horoscope and he had consultation with one or two other experts and came to the conclusion that this his horoscope and the girls were incompatible. His horoscope had the seventh house occupied by Mars. The seventh house being the one that indicated matrimonial aspects. The astrological text plainly stated that Mars in the seventh house indicated nothing but a disaster unless the partner's horoscope also contained the same flow, a case in which two wrongs makes one right. Anyway, somehow at last he married Raja. Okay, I think so all of you understood a very simple short story of R.K. Narayan, Mars in the seventh house. So kindly read the textbook well, go through the notes. So we will meet in the next class. Thank you.